been around for 110 to 120 million years.
Whoa.
So they were on the planet with the dinosaurs.
Wow.
And we all know what happened to the dinosaurs. They died out. But echidnas have survived, and that's why we have so much to learn about survival strategies and what they've done, how they've done it.
I'm heading east to Pelican Lagoon to meet a woman who knows more about echidnas than most people on the planet. But when I arrive at her rustic home and research centre, nestled in the bush, I realise I'm not the only visitor.
What have you got here, Peggy?
Well, I have Flat Frida and Flat Fred.
Whoa.
So I will just take them out of their little favourite t-shirt here. Both of these were roadkill.
Dr. Peggy Rismiller is a celebrated scientist originally from the United States who moved to the island in the late 80s to study the elusive short-beaked echidna.
We call them incentive mammals because you can't just come to Australia and expect to find an echidna. Mm. You really have to, you know, be in the bush and spend time. Nothing happens quickly. They've been around for a long time. And so we call it echidna time.
For over three decades, Peggy has been putting radio transmitters on echidnas. And with the help of volunteers and scientists, she's been able to track them and unravel a few mysteries. What about being an island makes the ecology on Kangaroo Island so special?
Being surrounded by water means that, you know, it's not always easy for things to get here. We don't have any rabbits. We don't have any foxes. So what we have here, we have plant and animal interactions, much as they were pre-European times. And you can't say that for any place else in Australia and probably many places in the world.
Now, when famous biologist and broadcaster Sir David Attenborough wants to film these ancient creatures, he calls on Peggy.
How did the fires impact the echidna population?
Actually, echidnas and goannas fared really well during the fires. Echidnas are great diggers, and most of them had dug in. So they dig down, move those spines around so that dirt goes between them, and they were very good at surviving the fires.
While Australia has always been a land of fire, now with global warming, our bushfires are more frequent and more savage. But here, there are plenty of signs of life.
As a biologist, fire is not devastating. Fire is actually a tool that, you know, has formed Australia. And so we say that it's a new starting point and things are coming back and it's beautiful the way it's coming back.
Peggy tells me there's not only been a lot of changes in nature, but also in attitudes towards it.
So conservation measures, I think, has become very personal for a lot of the landholders. We have our farming community that realises how important the native scrub is.
So you're seeing a little bit of a collaboration between some farmers and some greenies?
Well, absolutely. I like to say, yeah, we're not brown and green on the island. We're actually melting together to form, you know, a beautiful union of what nature is about.
Peggy said that on average it takes about 300 hours to find an echidna in the wild on KI. It must be my lucky day. He's massive.
He's not super happy with me being around, so he's burrowing right down in there, like they did during the fires. What a survivor.